Yeah. Let's talk about Pritchard a little bit. We're officially well past the point where we're going to stop. We're going to be surprised by him, right? Mm-hmm. At this point, there's no, I don't think he turns into a pumpkin at this point. I think they got them, you know, like, I think that period is already over, even though it's only been 11 games. He's a real ball player, like a valuable asset, startable point guard, theoretically, I think, if you needed it. But certainly, absolutely the guy you want running that second unit, and you want the guy you want with the ball in his hands. It's not even debatable at this point. He's a legit ball player. I mean, it's a, you know, I'd be shocked if it went too far in the other direction at any point in time. He just looks so in control and confident all the time. He plays like an 8-year veteran. I'm constantly, each time I'm amazed to the point where we have to stop being surprised by it. Right.
Yeah. I think I'm at that point. I feel like when he's out there, I mean, you nailed it, John. You said like, he looks like he's in control out there, and that's what it is. He's got like that presence. He's very aware of what's going on around him. I mean, he made a great, great pass from the three-point line tonight to Tice for that easy dunk. I mean, that was, you know, LaMelo ball-esque, if I may. I mean, I thought that was just a great play by him. Just tells you where his court awareness is, his vision. So I'm with you. I'm not really surprised anymore. I actually consider him, an important piece to where this team is going to be able to go. Not just this year, but we talked about this before the season. We talked about this before the season. We said the Celtics are going to need to hit in the draft because they don't have the cap space now. That ship is kind of sailed. They lost Gordon Hayward. They've had to make some moves where they're at that salary cap limit, and they need to hit on a couple of guys in the draft. And it looks like Pritchard, I'm not crowning him as an all-star, but you need depth guys. You need guys who are going to help you and contribute. And I feel like he's one of those guys. And I'll say this, him in there at the same time as Marcus Smart, what a wild combo of guys. I mean, it's like the yin and the yang out there, I feel like. I mean, you got Marcus Smart, who's kind of like all over the place and, you know, good at what he does, and you need him for what he does. Then you've got Pritchard, who's kind of a little bit more, and listen, he's energetic and crafty and all those things, but he might be a little bit more, I don't want to use the word reliable, but maybe reliable with some decision making and stuff like that.
I think you can go another route with that. They just like the angel and the devil thing, you know, like
maybe that too. I was thinking like the yin yang twins, though, you know what I mean? Like
one has to calm down the other, you know, vice versa at times.
Should I take the three? Oh yeah.
Hey, yeah. Another 40% night for Marcus Smart.
Yeah,
outside.
You gotta get Tatum's out tonight. Take the three. Yeah.
You gotta make a name for yourself.
yeah. You don't want all the shine to go to them, do you? Take the shot.
Take it, kid.
Yeah. If you don't, somebody else will.
You don't want that other rookie. No, but anyway, he was again great. Are we at all surprised how ho hum this game was? I know it's Orlando, but
that's it. It's Orlando. Mean,
you're still missing Tatum. Obviously, you're still missing Kemba. This was supposed to be a date we thought Kemba could theoretically play. But he didn't get enough practice. So he talked recently and he's, you know, still kind of talking about he's better than ever and ready to come back. But we could talk about it if we want to or not. But I was still a little surprised that this was such a cakewalk.
Yeah, I expected it with the original eight cast to be a 1-2 possession game. I figured it'd be more. I think the line moved to 10.5. Once they got Jalen. So the Celtics are pretty good at cleaning up these bad teams at home. We saw.
But that's what we were worried about before the season, though.
Yeah,
right?
We didn't expect games like this.
Because you thought,
sweeping away bad teams.
If we were saying, right, they can't mail in games, and if they're without a Jalen or Jason for any game, they can't just beat teams just walking in the gym. I mean, we've had that luxury watching them over the last few years where you could be out one, sometimes two people, and you still had three stars on the court. And you could still walk into Orlando and win these games almost every single time and not really sweat it. You were worried they didn't have it because we're looking at the bench. You know what I mean? Look at the starting lineup. It was Teague and Grant Williams, and Tristan went for his customary 2 points. You know, like that's three of your five starters tonight with Marcus and Jalen. I mean, that's not an impressive starting lineup. The bench again was awesome. Pritchard, Semi, good minutes, you know, from everybody there. But that's not like a fearsome starting lineup. It's surprising that you can walk in and just be able to manhandle an NBA team that way.
Thompson at four.
Okay, sorry.
Well, you know what?
We'll hold off on the apology, Cam.
What sticks out to me about this team is they nail shots. Like between Jalen spot up shooting, Semi surprise and catch and shoot game to start this year. Smart's been sensational shooting threes to start the year.
Another 40% night from three for them.
Yeah, and then Peyton Pritchard on top of it, the efficiency that he's showing. We're talking about a top five offense in terms of efficiency this year. And we came in and said, oh, if they turn it over too much, they're going to lose a lot of games. Well, they went on a string.
Turning it over a lot. Not tonight, but.
Well, yeah, they went on that string of like six or seven games where they had 10-plus, and they still ripped off.
They were 11 tonight, I think. But, I mean, they had a couple games that were 21, 18. I mean,
yeah, and they still won some of those because they hit shots. They're efficient. The offense this year, surprisingly, better than last year, so far at least. And you're missing, you know, Tice's activity in the front. Tristan's not giving you a ton there.
I was gonna call tonight.
Yeah. So, like, you just have more shot makers this year. Better wing play, that kind of stuff. And, you know, Brown's a big part of it. He was just outstanding again tonight.
Bobby's dying to talk about Jalen. We could talk about Jalen.
I mean,
yeah, you're right. You're just, right.
See, it becomes so casual to us at this
big
point.
Big screen well, on no, Bobby's Jalen talk.
The rest of us will go.
Though when they're shooting three pointers like the way they did 17 threes, like Shemi, I mean, those corner threes go a long way. We talked about that, you know, whether it's him or Grant Wood, that sort of has to be the routine, the norm with that second unit.
And Jalen did have an easy 21. You don't even really remember a lot of it.
You know why? He's shooting over 80% at the line this year.
I know.
Unreal.
Well, he did get to the free throw line seven times.
Should we dim the lights and light some candles for Bob as he talks about Jalen a little bit here?
Hey, he deserves it. 21 and 25, that's awesome.
Somebody said he hit 19 of his last 19 free throws. He hasn't missed in his last 19 free throws. So.
Yeah. How about Jeff Teague? He was good.
How about him?